Hello and welcome to the Guildhall Southampton. We're here tonight for a very special concert by the current Southampton Youth Orchestra, as well as an orchestra of past members who have returned for this special event. Tonight's concert marks the 25th anniversary of conductor and director Keith Smith, who after tonight is retiring. We've been speaking to some of the past members about their experiences, and of course Keith himself, who tells us his feelings on reaching this milestone. But of course, tonight is all about the music, so sit back and enjoy pieces by composers such as Tchaikovsky, Elgar and Shostakovich. The first piece you're going to hear is Dances from Estancia by Argentinian composer Alberto Ginastera.
Thank you.
Hello and welcome back. Russian composer Glazunov's Violin Concerto in A Minor is the next piece we'll be listening to. This wonderful and sometimes melancholic piece has been brought to life by talented soloist John Mills. But before that, we've been speaking to some of the past members of the orchestra and asked them what their fondest memories were of Keith Smith. Here's what they had to say.
Fondest memories would have to be being on tour with him. It's when he really sort of lets his hair down, the hair he has still, and he really showed how much fun music could be and all the things we got up to, which I probably shouldn't.
Is there a few things that you shouldn't say? Tell us some of them.
No, they shall remain
secrets.
Very.
The sheer enthusiasm that he can sort of, well, bully into us, but also cajole us as well. It's been an incredible experience for all of us, I think. And for the age we were, 12 to 18, to have somebody to enthuse us. And on occasions sort of demand it and shout at us, but it was the music making was the most incredible thing that I remember.
I think going on tour with him and all the organisation that he put into it and all the fun that we had with him.
He's this sort of spectre, it's a bit like the orchestral ghost, you know, 3 o'clock in the morning, there he'd be walking down the corridor in his little sandals going clink, 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 you know, keeps us all awake at night. Otherwise the students would be able to sleep, but, you know, I think that memory will go with us all for a long time.
As far as the orchestra is concerned, definitely the tours. The tours were always excellent. We spent a summer away with our best friends playing wonderful music. And as far as Keith's concerned, just an amazing presence at the front of the orchestra, bringing so many people through their teenage years, playing music and being with us in that sense. It was wonderful, amazing.
I think all the tours that we went on, I mean, we got to go to some amazing places. I went to Spain and on Canada, Portugal, Gibraltar, and just all the fun times we have. And Keith, you know, I think everyone has a love-hate relationship with Keith. He could be really nasty in rehearsals, but he's a fantastic person, and to have given up so much of his life to us is just amazing.
Thank you.
Hello and welcome back. Now, so far we've been listening to some brilliant music by the current Southampton Youth Orchestra, but what makes tonight so special is the return of men and women who grew up with Keith as their musical mentor. Now, they're going to play Tchaikovsky's Romeo and Juliet in just a minute, but first they've been telling us what kind of contribution they think Keith has made.
Well, he's been absolutely fantastic for the music making of the city. He has kept this youth orchestra going to an immensely high standard throughout difficult changes and different regimes, and he's always been there and demanding the highest standards, and he's kept those going, so that's all credit to him.
He's given so many people the opportunity to play at such a high standard, and just his driving enthusiasm still, we've all said when we've come back, it's exactly the same, and he's still shouting.
Well, everything in terms of his complete passion for the music is just so evident every time you rehearse with him. And just his the way that he eggs all of us on and drives us to do better constantly is really inspiring.
I think it's been enormous. He's brought literally almost thousands of people through with amazing musical experiences. It's been extraordinary for the length of time that he's been going and the number of friends that we've all made. I mean, the past members' orchestra is full of people and we've all met up again. It's been absolutely amazing. Extraordinary.
I think it's been immense, and I think without him it just wouldn't have been the same in the last, I don't know how many years it is he's been doing it, but certainly whilst I was in it he was the central focal point of the whole orchestra.
He's taken us around the world, he's done all the big events, you know, he's had the enthusiasm, hasn't always had the backing, but he struggled on and worked hard, and you can see that by the people we've got here today. You know, they've come back from 25 years and there are a lot of professionals out there who play in a lot of the orchestras in the country, and they all came here first. Thank you.
welcome back. Next up, we're going to hear Edward Elgar's variations on an original theme, played for us by the Past Members Orchestra. But before that, I managed to grab hold of Keith Smith for a brief moment to talk about his time as conductor. And I started off by asking him how he got the job in the first place.
Oh, it was a post that was advertised and I had to apply for and do an audition for. Of course, this is quite a long time ago. Now we're talking at the end of 1978.
Has it changed?
Oh, it's grown quite a lot, and the backing for the orchestra has changed immensely, and there are so many more youngsters learning now, so that we have a whole pyramid of youth orchestras leading to the senior orchestra.
Tell me, Keith, what's your fondest memories of your 25 years here?
I think this evening is going to be one of the most exciting memories. We've had some wonderful tours. We've played with wonderful soloists. We've been, you know, sort of with fine soloists all over the world, to China, to America, to Canada, all over Europe. So there are innumerable memories that flood back each time I meet somebody new.
What qualities will your successor need to have to fill your shoes?
I would hate to tell anybody how to do it. I'm sure that it's going to be very different. The orchestra now has grown up around my ideas, and I think it's time perhaps for a change.
So what are your plans now?
A bit of a holiday. I still have some conducting to do in Leicestershire and quite a lot of adjudicating at music festivals over the next 12 months or so. But I shall have to find some more work now.
And finally, what's your farewell message to the Southampton Youth Orchestra?
Oh, they have all my love and all my best wishes for the future, and I'm sure it will grow forever and blossom and go on. And one of the great things today is the fact that so many past members have come back from over the 25 years that I've been conducting the orchestra. They are so joyful to come back, meet me, but not only that, to play together again, meet old friends, meet new friends, and realise that the thing that they were playing and is still going on.
Thank you. Thank you.
and welcome back to the final part of the programme. Well, it's truly been an evening to remember, with performances by the current orchestra and past members' orchestra, both playing some fantastic music. But now it's time for the finale. Both orchestras will play the festival overture by Shostakovich. We hope that you join us in wishing all the best to Keith Smith in his retirement and thanking him for his commitment to music in Southampton. We leave you now with some farewell messages from past members. Goodbye.
Thanks for everything.
Thanks for all the music.
Keith, thank you so much. You've really made a difference to so many people's lives and given people opportunities they wouldn't normally have had, so enjoy having a relaxing retirement.
Thank you so much. I'm involved in music now professionally, and so many people on the stage are as well. It's just extraordinary. He's a massive reason why so many people have extraordinary memories of their childhood and playing in this way.
Thank you very much. Had a fantastic time, and because of you and the orchestra, I've really enjoyed music past after the orchestra. So thank you.